Hari Om, let's start with the prayer. Om Samasta Jana Kalyani Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsachanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhuscha Sakat Tvameva Tvameva Vijya Dravidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Amadeva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Gurudeva Deva Hari Om. We are doing the question and answer sessions, and today we pose a question: does Hinduism subscribe to Darwin's theory of evolution? This question comes because in the Western society, where the Christianity is dominant, they have a problem of teaching the evolutionary theory, Darwin's theory, in the school system, because it says that from a unicellular organism, then you have a increasing complexity of the organisms, and ultimately you have a mammalian, and then monkeys, and then from monkeys the human beings came. And that's what the Darwin's theory of evolution says, whereas the Bible says that Lord created human being. So the question is always, it says, oh, that's in conflict with the Bible. And therefore, the Christian missionaries and the priests, they don't want the children to learn the Darwin's theory of evolution, and they try to prove that that's wrong and so on and so forth. So what about Hinduism? Does it also have the same problem? I don't think so, because according to Hinduism, we have two evolutions. One is evolution according to the Darwin's theory is anatomical evolution. Evolution of the body. So body, mind, intellect, BMI equipments evolving, and he characterized the complexity of the system and says how a single cell all the way to come to a more complicated system. So it's an evolution of the body, and also sometimes even the mind and intellect, because as you go to higher and higher, they develop the mind and also develop the capacity to think. So there was who proved that even the plants have feelings, and a lot of people expect play music and all that. And of course, animals have a feeling. Once there was a big fire in New York, and the mother cat went in spite of the fire, and it went all the way in search of its babies to protect the babies, and brought the babies from the fire, and in the process it got burned, but that was a mother's love. So that emotional, the affinity for a mother is always there, even in animals also. Of course, human, they have a willpower, they have intellect to think, and therefore the evolution of the anatomical evolution, including BMI, is what Darwin's theory subscribes, and we have no problem also. But Hinduism also subscribes more than the anatomical evolution, evolution of the soul. Soul, according to that, is the life force enters into an appropriate body to exhaust the vasanas. It can be going up or make a detour, and also take a detour where it can go back into animal life and come back again. And we have a story in the Upanishads, the story of Jadabharata. So Jadabharata story is where a sage is almost purified his mind. He was almost ready to realize the self-realization or God-realization. But he had a small deer that he was taking care of it. So he was having so much attachment and love for the deer and worried about what's going to happen to the deer when he leaves the body. So that was his more concern. So his attachment to the deer has essentially brought him down, and instead of going up. So therefore, when he died, the body died, and he has born again as a deer because of his attachment to the deer body. But he had, since he was evolved, he had the memory of what happened in that previous life, and therefore he contemplating on it even though he is in the deer body. And next time, in the next life, he born again as a human being, but he kept quiet and concentrated mostly on self-realization. So he took a detour to be born as a deer and came back again, and evolution of the soul rapidly progresses. So therefore, we have no problem in terms of evolution of the soul versus the anatomical evolution. Anatomically, a human being may be more evolved compared to amoeba or small insects and virus and so on. But you take appropriate life form to exhaust the vasanas that you have so that you will rapidly progress. So it's a detour. So in the process, you are only exhausting, in animal life, you are only exhausting vasanas. So question is, how did the animals got vasanas? So obviously, according to Hinduism, one is born as a human being where one accumulates the vasanas, and he will be born again into different animals in order to certain things. Exhausted can only be in the animal form, and he takes a detour and comes back. So anatomical evolution can be different from a spiritual evolution, and spiritual evolution also can go rapidly, also progresses once you are in the human birth. This is what Arjuna asked the question, what happens to a person when he dies? He didn't realize it. At the same time, he didn't enjoy life also. Enjoyment, sense enjoyments. So he's called Vayabhrashtaha. So Krishna laughs and says, there is no problem for him. He will, all that will be helpful for him in the next life. So he will be born in a conducive environment for his rapid growth. So therefore, you see Mahatmas suddenly turn and see either Ramana Maharshi's story or anybody's story, so whatever prompts them, and suddenly they take off. And what was that? Because they already have a previous samskara in the past life. So someone asks, Ramana Maharshi didn't have a guru, why should I have a guru? That's good. But Ramana Maharshi, see, according to Vedanta, guru is required. He must have had the prayer in the previous samskara. He already has the background information needed for him to take off. That is the guarantee of the Lord himself. So therefore, does Hinduism subscribe to Darwin evolution? We have no problem with it. It's an anatomical evolution which is different from a spiritual evolution. With that, we stop. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamiva Vasishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Guru Bhyo.